Hello, this is your daily dose of news from On Manorama. I'm your host Vishnu and these are the major news stories of the day. Russia's first lunar mission in 47 years smashes into the moon in failure. People of Ladakh are concerned over their grazing land being taken over by the Chinese army, says Congress leader Rahul Gandhi. Congress President Mallikarjun Kharge forms new Congress Working Committee, includes G23 members including Shashi Tharoor and Anand Sharma. Kerala government inaugurates ₹2,400 crore solid waste management project. Messi magic lifts Inter Miami to League's Cup title. Let's get into the details. Russia's first moon mission in 47 years failed when its Luna 25 spacecraft spun out of control and crashed into the moon after a problem preparing for pre-landing orbit, underscoring the post-Soviet decline of a once mighty space program. Russia's state space corporation, Roscosmos, said in a statement that the apparatus moved into an unpredictable orbit and ceased to exist as a result of a collision with the surface of the moon. A soft landing had been planned for Monday. It said a special interdepartmental commission had been formed to investigate the reasons behind the loss of the Luna 25 craft, whose mission had raised hopes in Moscow that Russia was returning to the big power moon race. The failure underscored the decline of Russia's space power since the glory days of Cold War competition when Moscow was the first to launch a satellite to orbit the Earth, Sputnik 1 in 1957, and Soviet cosmonaut Yuri Gagarin became the first man to travel into space in 1961. It also comes as Russia's $2 trillion economy faces its biggest external challenge for decades, the pressure of both Western sanctions and fighting the biggest land war in Europe since World War II. Congress leader Rahul Gandhi on Sunday claimed that Prime Minister Narendra Modi's assertion that not an inch of the land in Ladakh has been taken over by China is not true. The people of Ladakh are concerned about their grazing land being taken over by the Chinese army, Gandhi, who is on a tour of Ladakh, said after paying tributes to his father and former Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi on his birth anniversary. The Congress leader said he was planning to visit Ladakh during his Bharat Jodo Yatra but had to abandon the plan due to some logistical reasons. The Congress has been questioning the government over the border situation with China. Indian and Chinese troops are locked in an over three-year confrontation in certain friction points in eastern Ladakh even as the two sides completed disengagement from several areas following extensive diplomatic and military talks. India has been maintaining that its ties with China cannot be normal unless there is peace in the border areas. Congress President Mallikarjun Kharge on Sunday reconstituted the party's top decision-making body, the Congress Working Committee. While 39 members of the all-important panel are general members, it has 32 permanent invitees, including some in charges of state, and 13 special invitees, including presidents of the Youth Congress, the National Students' Union of India, the Mahila Congress, and the Seva Dal as ex-officio members. Shashi Tharoor, Anand Sharma and Mukul Vasnik, who were part of the group of 23 leaders that had raised questions on the party's leadership under Sonia Gandhi, are among the general members of the new panel. Manish Tiwari and Veerappa Moili, who were also part of the grouping, have been made permanent invitees. Former Punjab Chief Minister Charanjit Singh Channi and Pratibha Singh have also been included in the important panel, according to a Congress statement. Sachin Pilot, who rebelled against the party's government in Rajasthan and was later removed as Deputy Chief Minister, is also among the new working committee members. As part of the second phase of Kerala's Malinya Muktam Navakeralam, which is a garbage-free campaign, Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan inaugurated the ₹2,400 crore Kerala Solid Waste Management Project on Sunday. Addressing a gathering, Vijayan said Kerala was being urbanized at a rapid pace and urged everyone to join hands to achieve a garbage-free Kerala. He said that as per reports, at least 90% of the state's population will be urbanized by 2035 and that there are opportunities as well as challenges in this regard. He said adapting to modern techniques for waste management is part of addressing the challenges. The Chief Minister also said the aim was to make Kerala a model before the world in waste management by 2024. The ambitious project is being carried out by KSWMP in association with the World Bank and Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank. Inter Miami beat Nashville SC in a thrilling Leagues Cup final on Saturday after a 1-1 tie was settled by a marathon 10-9 penalty shootout, as Lionel Messi extended his winning streak since joining the MLS side to 7 games. Messi opened the scoring in the 23rd minute, notching his 10th goal of the inaugural tournament with a blistering shot from distance past multiple defenders and into the top left corner of the net. Nationals' Fafa Picoll levelled for the home team in the 57th minute, and both teams came agonisingly close to taking the lead in the roller coaster second half. In the shootout, Nashville goalkeeper Elliot Panico missed the final kick of the night to deliver Inter Miami, who joined the league in 2020, their first trophy. Messi's overjoyed teammates tossed the Argentine in the air as ecstatic Miami co-owner David Beckham shook his fist above his head in triumph. The trophy is Messi's 44th, the most by any player. The 7-time Ballon d'Or winner was named player of the tournament. That brings us to the end of this episode. Thanks for listening to Daily News Toast, hosted and produced by me, Vishnu Muralidharan, with technical support from Idea Brew Studios. Follow on manorama.com for detailed updates on the latest news, and be sure to come back tomorrow.